All right, I'm sorry I'm so late getting this video. I made a recording, but the mic didn't record correctly last time, so I'm just going to do this again as I'm getting ready to go into the MZRS. So I already have the MZRS loaded, and you were asking how I get all my overlays and things floating in Steam VR. Now, this is on a HP Reverb 2 now, which handles the overlays pretty well. You don't have to worry about any extensions for Chrome with this because you actually go over here and open JRT Overlays. When you do that, you get these overlays right here. There's my dashboard. Timing doesn't usually show up until I load the actual race server. It's usually supposed to stay invisible otherwise. And what I do then is I take this one floating desktop with my controller here, and I load it in the world. And then I usually like to have it about 75%, throw it up here kind of out of the way. I know how to line it up because when I open the dashboard, for me, it just happens to be that if I put this right on top of where the dashboard's sitting, it'll be right above my mirror. Then I float the dashboard, drop it to 25%. I like to push it forward just a little and then put it roughly about right here. And that's usually about where it's going to need to be. Just kind of learn from experience. Then I have JRT Timing 3, which I customized to work like a relative, but it tells me who I don't like are on the track, or teammates, which I do like, or teammates that I don't like, which can happen. All right, then there you go. I got those two in place. Then I float the spotter, and when I float it, it looks like a gray box here, but I'm going to go ahead and move it up to about right there. And I don't shut my mic off or shut my battery off on this controller yet because I may need to adjust them. But as soon as I hit the far right button, not the B or the A or the Windows button, but that far right menu button, all of the transparent overlays disappear. Okay, so here I am. I'm going to go ahead and keep recording here in a little bit after I qualify so that you can see how the spotter works. And actually, before I qualify, you can see I don't like how low my dashboard is sitting. I don't know how easy it is to see. So I go back here and I click on the desktops, and that gets everything out of my way. I like where the spotter is, but I'm going to move the dashboard up a little bit higher. I'm going to move my relative up a little bit higher. Just don't like where it's sitting in this car. I check it. I can move the dashboard even higher. So I might even move the spotter just a little bit higher. There, because I like it sitting just underneath the windshield. Once I've got that set, I can go ahead and turn off my hand controller to save battery, because with my butt kicker on, it does not shut off. It keeps thinking it's fixed. All right, right back after qualifying. Okay, here we are on the grid. You're going to start seeing the spotter go into effect here in just a little bit when a car shows up beside me. He has not gridded yet. Qualified so-so. I'm not great in this car, but I haven't had the energy to learn Red Bull this week, so, or the time. So you can see how much information I have on the display, and I've added a lot of stuff on here. That tire I custom, that was an option that's not normally there. The available tires is really helpful in oval racing. I can see what my fuel was set to right there. Those I all added custom. The clocks down here and the tire temperatures or tire percentages I also added as custom. I can see my real clock and the track temp clock. Over here is my custom relative. I keep this real relative box up here. I kind of look at it sometimes too, but that's mostly for making pit stop adjustments. So the spotter doesn't seem to be showing up.
Jetstar 18, car, Jetstar 8, car, Jetstar 22, car, Jetstar 12, car, get the 20, car, get the 15, car, get the 21, car, get the 19, car, get the 29.
Oh, there it is. Car. Now it's working. See, as I'm going by the cars, it'll show me where they are relative to my car. And once we get into full race speed, it'll actually show which side they're on. It doesn't during caution laps. So once you feel like you like seeing how the spotter works, feel free to not continue watching this video. I'm not monetized or anything. But I'm gonna go ahead and record the race since I don't stream anymore. But you're seeing what I see. I have all this up here. I don't ever really look up there except under caution, or if I'm spotting for a teammate in an endurance event. Doing everything I can to actually get heat into the cars. You can see if I make a change to like the brake bias, I see it on my dashboard right there. Or if I make a change to my fuel amount, it'll flash it up there.
Get the 29 car. Get ready, going green.
Oh no, not here.
Get the 29 car, green, green, green.
So I have a button set with JRT that automatically gives me just enough fuel to finish. Missed a shift there. 31 is going to get to me because I missed that shift. And of course he's going to dive it. I'm not as familiar with the engine on this car and the timing of the shifts. So I just waited too long and hit the chip. You might can tell on my little display board that I actually have the tires already cleared. And I'm able to confirm that without having to change my black box. Oh, somebody hit him. What a dummy.
I still don't get it. You're already in the back of the field. Where are you going?
A lot of carnage on lap 1 and 2.
All good. Thank you for the apology.
There's carnage up here. I almost need a mouse with a slightly stickier surface because it's always sliding around with my butt kicker. I think Joel's got pace on me. So I can see exactly how fast he's catching me with those little blue arrows there. And he's got momentum on me. He's probably gonna get inside.
2:08.535 right side. Clear on the right.
And right now I'm really not paying any attention to the dashboard or not even really the relative so much. I peek over at the relative every once in a while just to look for the green numbers and the red numbers to see who I'm kind of faster on that lap, and I can see if I've been faster on that lap or slower on that lap.
Rejoin that 22, really appreciate you really killing both of us.
Sorry about that, man. I didn't mean to be that close.
That was a really bad corner.
A 2:08.854.
I'm gonna take this in third this time. See if it's... No, that's not faster. You might notice another thing I did when I set up my timing overlay that I want there is it shows more cars than the regular relative. On the outside. You'll also notice on my dashboard right now, I have it set to show me exactly who's behind me, not where I am in position. I can push this button right here, and now I see my position battles instead of who's right behind me.
2:08.559.
But most of the time in the multi-class, I just want to know who's closing, how close. It's the best relative for me, really, is that dashboard. So I know exactly how close the person in front and behind is. I'm not making great time. Screwed that corner up. Mostly because I was trying to give him room. Alright, let's see if this guy is crazy enough to dive in the kink, because I am not backing out of the kink.
Right side. Clear on the right.
What are you doing? Nicholas, are you stupid?
I could say the same thing to you, buddy. Why are you blocking a guy who's clearly faster than you, then completely running me off the fuck?
I had the inside line. Are you stupid?
You were blocking me when I was very clearly faster than you. You had damage. Are you...
Yeah, you had 3/4 of the track on the right-hand side. Open your eyes.
I was clearly on the left side of the track, and then you fucked...
No, you were not. You're stupid.
Shut the fuck up, dude. Enjoy your protest.
I'm good. Good luck.
2 minutes, 9.759.
Oh, are you crazy? You're a fucking crazy.
Oh, I'll stop talking when I was trying to be nice to the LMP bars.
Thank you, Ness. I'm sorry.
Damn, Joel doing me dirty. You can't move back over in the middle of the braking zone, dude.
It's going into Canada corner, dude. Come on. You're like a full car behind me, too. What are you trying to do?
You moved twice. In reaction to me.
2 minutes, 8.796.
You there, mate?
Car on your left. Clear on the left. Car on your left. Clear on the left.
Bye, Felicia.
minutes, 8.323.
Whoa.
Two minutes, 7.51.
Thanks, Scott.
Whoops.
Go, go, go!
Looks like both of those Williams didn't have good pit stops, or they took way too much fuel. The set is tight. Push loose. Get off that grass. And, get off that grass. Damn it. Thank you.
Roosty boy!
I was giving it to you anyway, man.
2 minutes, 7.929.
Hey, Dan, I wasn't trying to tap you. I was trying to side draft. Sorry about that.
Car right. Clear. On the right.
Go right, go right. Thank you. You're welcome, Steve.
God damn it.
Car right, clear on the right, right side. Clear.
I just cannot. I tried driving in deep and it just didn't work. I locked these brakes up too easy. Another mistake.
2 minutes, 7.236. You've got about 2 laps of fuel.
Why is the fucking fuel mileage changed? This happened last race. It changed how many laps we were going to run at the last minute.
our one lap of fuel left. Right side. Clear on the right. White flag. Stay
there
through.
We go. Say, they have just enough fuel. I had to let him catch me. That was part of it. Alright, not terrible. I wish I hadn't given that one spot back.
There's the flag. It's over. Great job. You did really well.
If you've watched to this point, I hope that gives you an idea of how it all works.